This video I'm going to be talking about Medium, and as you should know by now that Medium has already disabled its SEO feature for spammy content. So this is an example of a piece of article that I had ranking on Google and was generating for me about 20 to 30 visitors every single day using free Google traffic. So we need to understand why Medium is around. Medium goes on and says that the heart of Medium's mission is to deepen the understanding, and we believe that the best way to accomplish that mission is to be an open platform, a place where anyone can voice their opinions regardless of background, affiliation or expertise. You don't need to be an expert in any niche. You can just head over to Medium and create a blog. So people have gone on to misuse Medium, and this is why they have disabled their SEO feature. They go on and say to protect their mission, it is imperative that we have systems in place to support the system of creators who are here to share ideas and connect with readers, and discourage creators who sorry are leveraging Medium for SEO, which would be spam and serving clickbait. So the common pattern here that I'm noticing is spam and clickbait. So Medium goes on and says Medium limits content that is made available to third-party search engines as well as Medium search and tag pages. The overwhelming majority of content that Medium will no longer be allowing to be indexed is that most people will consider as spam, and the net effect of more traffic to quality content in the long term. So this means that if you're not writing content that serves the reader but only benefits you, is that Medium won't rank your content. So the common pattern I'm noticing here is spam and clickbait. So what does that mean? It means that if you exhibit any sort of spam, your Medium account will be shut down and you'll get that message. So what does Medium consider as spam? These are very simple things, but we as Medium writers, we don't always take the time to read the Medium rules. One is driving traffic off of Medium. Yes, I would agree, I've done this I myself, is that we write affiliate content on Medium. We write linking back to our website to build backlinks and reposting from other resources, that is scraping content and all other forms of different ways we can get people off of their platform, which is what they don't want. So duplicate content from other websites or scraping content using article spinners, misuse of their own site for our own benefit, that is linking out to our own website to get traffic. Affiliate posts that offer no value. They allow affiliate links, but they have to be valuable. So it is at this moment that I say that you should avoid JVZoo, Warrior Plus, ClickBank, and specifically ClickBank for some niches, let's say weight loss and making money online. So spammy cryptocurrencies, I don't like crypto, and that's why I don't even waste time making videos about it. Restricted content, I'll be explaining this in detail. So some of the restricted categories on Medium include the promotion of controversial, suspect and extreme content, gambling and betting, copyright and intellectual property violation, illegal hacking services, and so much more. So these are categories that you should regularly stay away from if you're writing on Medium, and it is important that you go ahead and read the Medium rules. I'll leave a link to this as well in the description of this video. Head on here and read through these rules. They're important if you're considering to continue writing on Medium. For those who are looking forward to another way to go on in there on Medium and utilize the SEO feature they have ready for you guys, then keep watching the video.
If you're enjoying the content so far, please be sure to leave a like and subscribe to the channel to let YouTube's algorithms know that we are fast becoming one of your best content creators on their platform. This is important because YouTube has been hiding our content as of lately, and you'll also stay updated with all our future uploads.
For more, you should check the links in the description. I've included a link to this very article, so you can go ahead and check it out. They go on and say that this system is similar to Google's PageRank. Sort of like an algorithm, right? So I guess they have introduced an algorithm that is gonna be monitoring quality content over spammy content. So that means that in order to make it onto the first page of Google, we have to pass certain benchmarks that have been put in place by Medium and their team or staff. So they go on and say that, and this will result into legitimate Medium creators ranking higher across all Google searches. So if you show Medium that you are a creator that is using their platform to help their readers rather than for your own benefit, they will reward you accordingly and you rank on Google in the long run. So this means that we should go on and create high quality content, as I'll be showing you later on in this video. So stick around with me all the way through to the end. So this is important, and this is why they have disabled the SEO feature for many people. So I think that the stories that are getting indexed as per moment are those that are valuable, and Medium didn't consider them as spammy, and they have still maintaining their position in the Google searches. So you can see that they go on and say, keep engaging on the Medium community and publishing your best work. It can take up to days to weeks to hit the thresholds required to be indexed. So to be indexed, it can take up to days or weeks. So if you're showing them signs of publishing high quality content, they'll go on and put you onto the first page of Google in just a couple of days, which is amazing, because you have already showed them that you are an authority and you are not just here to spam on their website. This is really important, because most people who have been using Medium for their own benefits were not helping the reader. So if I'm not being indexed yet, how can people find my account? So this is only referring to people who have had a wider readers audience. So those people with followers on Medium, they will obviously be able to be found by their readers and followers. So what are the solutions? The solutions are very simple, and I've come up with a couple of them, and I'll be explaining them right now. Okay, so once we get into Medium, the first thing we need to do is we need to look at the titles, what content is doing well on the platform. So if you don't have a niche, it doesn't matter. With Medium, you don't need a niche. That is something that I really liked about this platform. So you can see here the trending content. You can see it's very short content, 4 minute read, 9 minute read. And if you can't write a 3 minute read article, then it's gonna be hard for you. You need to just make videos if you can't write. So then the other thing that I really liked about this is that people write about what they want, and there's no barrier to entry, which is something that's good. So you can go out there and write about politics, you can write about technology, money, whatever you want. They don't mind, so long as you're not going against their rules. So it's important to read the rules. Then the first way we're going to do this is we're going to find content that's trending. So how do we find this content? Simple. We need to head over to Twitter. That's the first platform we're going to be using. Head over to Twitter, then we'll switch over to the trending tab. So this trending tab is going to be showing us the content that's currently getting the most traction at the moment. So we can look through here, you can see that these are the people that are getting the most attention on Twitter. So if we can write about them, that means we shall also perform better on Google and on the Medium reader platform. That's something that's really good. And if you don't know, if you want to go into a specific niche, I'll leave a video in the description down below that will show you step by step how to find those rare niches that you can go for as well. Then the other way we can find these easy keywords is we can use a site like Reddit. Reddit is another good one, and all you need to do is to head over to Reddit and get an account. If you don't have one, then click on this arrow here that says popular, or you can access this one also using the drop down menu. Just hit on here and scroll through to the bottom, you'll see the popular one here. So you can see that the trending topics here at the top is that the trending topics getting the traction as per moment on Reddit. And one thing that I really liked about Reddit is that you can head over into here and look through to the specific subreddits that get a lot of engagement, then just write the same content in your own words. So let me show you an example of what I mean here. So if you look here, you can see the Guardian. Somebody share, I don't know, I think it's the Guardian themselves, they share this content. So you can head over here and click through and look through to see what content these people are writing. You can write that in your own words. And let me show you an example of somebody who is doing this. So if you head over to Medium here, you can see that I was wrong about Christy Teigen. I even don't know this lady, but I think she's a celebrity of some kind. I don't know. But you can see Shannon actually is writing about her. So I don't know what the topic is about, but this is written just a couple of days ago, 8 minute read, and it's already popular in media. So you can even write about celebrities, write about their life, what they are doing on a daily basis. And another way to find these trending topics is by using Google Trends. So Google Trends, just head over there and type in your topic. It doesn't have to be technology, it can be something about sports or celebrities. And one thing I like about this Google Trends is that you can see here they give you the title already to go. So you can see Netflix series about unintended consequences of new technology. So you can just copy that, paste it in your title, and just start writing about it. If you don't know about the topic, search for it, write it in your own words. Another way we can use Google Trends is by using the real-time search trend. So we can look through here and see what is trending in real time. So like in the past 24 hours, you can see that the Smash Bros, I even don't know who they are, but they are trending at the moment. Then you can see the Restless, Summer Newman, you can write about them. Then the nails one, so 9-inch nails, I don't know what happened to her nails, but just write about the nails and how they went 9 inches long, whatever. Then another way we can find these trends is we can use Pinterest. So Pinterest is another good one. So you can just head over to Pinterest. You don't even need to enter any query, but they will show you what's trending on Pinterest as per moment. And this is good because you can just create 5 pins, just 5 pins. Then we link back to our very article to show Medium that we are not just relying on their readers or on their own its authority to get views to our articles. So that's one thing, or one way of building trust with them. So if you want to show them that you're an authority, show them that you can get traffic without their readers and see your feature. So that's one way of building trust. The other way we're going to be building this trust is we shall go on and we shall ensure that we are writing 30 to 50 articles without links. That is something that people always forget. They want to write an article, add a link, add a link, add a link. No, write 30 articles without links. It's that simple. Just write 30 articles without links. And it's literally easy. You just have to write 3-minute articles without links. It's that easy. You can just write about the best summer office 2021. You don't need to link to anybody. But you can use these images, then you can source them out. You can source images from Pixabay. You can buy your own images. You can also take images of yourself. It's that easy. If you're into cooking, there are topics here to go for. So that's one, that is an easy way to find these trending topics.
Okay, guys. So the other way we can get around this SEO blocking feature of Medium, which I believe is an algorithm now, is by creating your own free website. So there are a bunch of ways you can create a free website. So the one that I really like is the Blogger one, and I'm gonna be making a video after this one. It's gonna be coming out in the future. All you need to do is to like this video, subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss when it drops. So I'm gonna be showing you everything from setting up the website, getting approved for iGoogle AdSense, everything, all the way from a beginner to an expert. I'm going to be talking about things that you may or may not have heard of, so stay tuned for that. So you can see this is one of the Blogger websites that I own, and it has only 30 articles written on it, and it is in a specific niche that I won't tell you, but I'll not show you the domain and the articles that's ranking for. But you can see that on a daily basis we are averaging about 20 visitors, or on some days it's about 18 17, but on average it's about 20 visitors every single day, and in a week it can equal to hundreds of visitors. So on some good weeks I can go up to 200. So it has only 30 articles written on it, and it's making about $20 to $30 every single day for free, and it's the monetization strategy is using ClickBank. It's a ClickBank product. It's around the specific ClickBank product, and I will show you that in the coming video. I won't show you the website, but I will show you how to do exactly what I'm doing on this website. So 176 visitors this very week so far, and
the new week has just started. By the time I'm recording this video, it's Monday, so this is a new week. We don't know what will happen in the new week, but we have, yesterday it was 30 people to the website, which is great and amazing. So you can see average time on the page is 3 minutes 58, which is good, and 149 unique page views. Great. Bounce rate is little bit high, but we can get that low, and I'll show you that in the video. So all you need to do is to hit the like on this video, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you guys in the next video.